The barrows. What are the barrows? Are they a place where you put all the barrels? And then you drink all of the grog that you want? You know, until they run dry? Is that what the barrows are? Is it a place like you go and you have a good time with your friends? No! The barrows... What is it? Really? I want to know. Stick around. I think you'll like it. In our countdown to Shadow of War, we're going to discuss what the barrows are. Yesterday we talked with Minas Yeleth and we mentioned briefly, or at least I did, about the barrows. And today we're going to talk more about what they are. So stick around. The barrows are only able to be played as Celebrimbor. That's fascinating. As the devs have said, you can only play it as Celebrimbor. We're going to unpack the history of Celebrimbor more in Shadow of War, which is always fascinating. We've got a little bit of a, you know, look into Celebrimbor's life through the flashbacks that the main storyline showed for us whenever Talion was to discover another artifact with the help of his trusty, very, very trustworthy Smeagol friend. No, Golem's not so trustworthy as he tried to throw a rock and kill him in the Shadow of Mordor series. But either way, we know we got to get a glimpse of Celebrimbor's past. Well, they're going to expand that a whole lot more. A character that's largely been unknown. I mean, trying to figure out more who he is, what he did, what he's all about. We're going to find out a whole lot more in Shadow of War. So very excited about that. I think it's a great storyline, one that I'm captivated about. Captivated. And captivated sounds like an envelope has captivated me. That's a horrifying thought. I'm going to have a bad dream about this. It's going to be like a horror of envelopes cutting me and then packing them and shipping me to Timbuktu. Okay, I got sidetracked there. But anyway, it's still captivating. By doing this, they say, we relive the most powerful orcs of that time and unlock his legendary gear set. So, not only are we discovering Celebrimbor's story, we're also discovering more about powerful orcs. The most powerful orcs of that time. You know, thousands of years or so, however, what is it? I don't know, 1,000 years of Celebrimbor. We're going to fight him as Celebrimbor. And the Wraith Ring gives us the power. So, you know, the Wraith world, well, we talked about that in a previous episode about the ring. That's what we use to go into these Wraith worlds and discover more. And that's what the barrels are. They're a Wraith world of Celebrimbor's past. Now, we also need to learn that these storylines help us to get legendary gear sets. That's very important and worth doing because legendary gear is, well, it's awesome. It's legendary. Rewards from doing such is by exploration. There's puzzles to be revealed and cool gear in the barrows. So it's worth going and doing these. I think it's going to be a fun kind of side mission, kind of to give a break from all the blood and gore of siege missions and take a nice casual approach at going at it. But it doesn't seem all casual because there still is those most powerful orcs they talked about. Where do they come into play? Interesting. Now, furthermore, upon completion, we learn about his side of the story. Very great. And they also say we unlock being able to use the axe as a throwing tomahawk, baby. Yes. A story unlock mission that helps us in battle. I'll take that. And this is something very cool because the tomahawk can now be used as a projectile, as we've seen in the gameplay. And I can't wait to unlock that. So, that's pretty awesome. And on that note, let's talk about this hammer. The community asks, so what weapons can be switched and thrown? And here they talk about the hammer, or the tomahawk, a little more. The hammer is considered ranged, more of an explosive mid-range AOE type of weapon. The shotgun, if you will. And we can switch out the bow for the hammer, however, we can't quick switch. So here's a side note for those that are thinking you can just switch back and forth from a shotgun move to a bow that's more precise and long range. No, you can't do it quick. They balance it with making it switch a little slower. Well, you gotta balance it somehow, right? You gotta balance it somehow. So, that's how they do it. Well, very cool. Can't wait to use the hammer as a shotgun, as they named it. Looking forward to that. And that is it on the barrows. Hopefully you enjoyed this episode. If you did, don't forget to hit a like. You know all how that goes. And I'll see you in tomorrow's episode as we talk about microtransactions. Oh boy. See you there.
Thanks for watching. And don't forget to slam that like button with a bone-shattering wraith punch to the face. The harder you smash it, the better. No, really. It really helps this channel out.